In this video, I explain what is simple gear train and find out the equation of velocity ratio for simple gear train. Now, what is the meaning of gear train? When the series of gear are used, then it is called as the gear train. So, in this diagram, the various four gear are used, so it is called as the gear train. So, in a simple gear train, so gear train have a various four types. One is the simple gear train, second is compound, third one is riveted and epicyclics. So, in a simple gear train, series of gear wheel means series of gears are mount on different shaft, and between the driving and driven shaft, each shaft carrying only one gears. So, here you see in this diagram, four gear are there, gear A, gear B, gear C and the gear D. It is called as the series of gear. And all the gears are mounted on a different shaft. Here you see this part is called as the shaft. So this is shaft A. On a shaft A, gear A is mounted. On a shaft B, gear B is mounted. On a shaft C, gear C is mounted. On the shaft D, gear D is mounted. Means in a simple gear train, on a one shaft, only one gear is mounted. It is called as a simple gear train. Second type is a compound gear train. For that, I will make the separate videos. In a compound gear trains, in a single shaft, more than one gears are mounted. Means two gear, three gears are mounted. Then it is called as the compound gear trains. So, consider A is the driving gear. So, this is a A. It is a driving gear. Driving gear means it is connected with main power source or a prime mover, means it is connected with the IC engines, it may be connected with the electric motor, means they are connected with the power source. D is the driven gear, means D gear is run by using the gear A, B and C. B and C is the intermediate gear as shown in a figure. So, these B and C are installed between the driving gear and the driven gear, so it is called as the intermediate gear. Means power is transmitted from the shaft A to shaft D, and due to intermediate gears, the rotation of the gear, means direction of rotation of the gear, is also changed. Means gear is rotated clockwise, anti-clockwise, they are also changed. The intermediate gear change the direction of rotation of driven gears. Means if the here in this diagram you see that two intermediate gear are there, B and C. Suppose only one intermediate gear are used, then what is the direction of driven gears? If the two intermediate gears are used, then what is the direction of the driven gears? If 3, 4, 5 are used, then what is the direction of the driven gears? So, therefore, it is also known as the idler gear. When number of intermediate gear are even, even number means 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Okay. So, here in this diagram, we see that two intermediate gears are there, means it is in a even numbers. Then what happens? The driven gears rotate opposite directions of the driving gear. Means suppose the A gear, it is our driving gear, it is rotated clockwise. Then the gear B is rotated anti-clockwise. Then gear C is rotated clockwise and the gear D is rotated anti-clockwise. Means driving gear is rotated in a opposite directions of the driven gears. Now here in this diagram A, only two gears are there. So this is rotated clockwise, then it is rotated anti-clockwise. Then we add the one idler gears, then what happens? Driving and driven gears are rotated in a same direction. Here we see driver is rotated in a clockwise direction, then the driven gear is also rotated in a clockwise directions. When the even numbers of gear are there, then the directions of the driver and driven gears are opposite to each other. Means when the even number of gears are there, means 2, 4, 6, driver and driven are rotated in opposite directions. Odd numbers of gear are there, means 1 gear, 3 gear, 5 gear, 7, 9, 11 and more. Then the driver and driven gears are rotated in a same directions. So, sometimes in a MCQ exam, these types of the question is asked to find out the direction of these gears. Just we need to count the idler gears. It is odd numbers or even numbers. So, we can directly say that it is rotated in same directions or in opposite directions. Now, we are find out the velocity ratio of a simple gear train. Before moving on that, I request to like the video and subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to basic mechanical engineering or other subject of mechanical engineering. For basic mechanical engineering, various link is provided in descriptions. as well as in car. For other subject, I request to visit the playlist. Now we find out the velocity ratio for simple gear train. For that, we consider the few parameters like as the NA, NB, NC and ND are the RPM. RPM means revolutions per minute. For gear A, RPM is NA. For gear B, RPM is NB. For gear C, RPM is NC. For gear D, RPM is ND. TA, TB, TC and TD are the number of teeth on the gear A, B, C, D respectively. Means for gear A, teeth A is denoted as the TA. For gear D, teeth is denoted as the TD. So, first we find out the velocity ratio between the gear A and B. So, in a last video, we already find out the equation of velocity ratio. So, this similar equation is applied for all the gears. Okay. So, velocity ratio for gear is the NB upon NA is equal to TA upon TB. So, RPM is equal to the number of teeth and it is opposite. Okay, here you see the NB upon NA is equal to TA upon TB. So, this equation is find out by using the equation of the pitch circle diameters. Second is the velocity ratio between the gear B and C. So, NC divided by NB is equal to teeth of the gear B, TB divided by teeth of the gear C, TC. So, velocity ratio is generally the RPM of the output shaft upon RPM of the input shaft. So, here first A and B is connected. So, we find out the gear ratio for A and B. Then after power from the B is transferred to the power gear C. Okay, so we can find out the velocity ratio for B and C. Then after the power from the gear C is transferred to the power D. Okay, so next we find out the velocity ratio between the C and D. So, for the C and D, output is the gear D. So, it is ND. So, ND upon NC is equal to TC upon TD. So, this is equation number 3. So, velocity ratio between the driving and driven gear is given by. So, output gear is ND. Means output gear is D. And the RPM of the D gear is the ND. And input gear is the gear A. So, we need to find out ND upon NA. So, ND upon NA is equal to NB upon NA into NC upon NB into ND upon NC. Now, instance of NB upon NA, we put this equation. Instance of NC upon NB, we put this value. Instance of ND upon NC, we put this value. So, here we putting this value in a term of the teeth, instance of the speed. So, here now this TB, this TB is cancelled. This TC and TC is also cancels. So, ND upon NA is equal to TA upon TD. So, it is called as the velocity ratio of a simple gear drive. Means, by using these equations, we are able to find out the speed of gear D or speed of gear A, or we can also able to find out the teeth of the any one gear. So, when you solve the numericals, the any one parameters are unknown. So, by using this equation, we can solve the numericals. So, thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like the video, subscribe my channels and don't forget to share with your friends.